This One News update is brought to you by ANZ, proud sponsor of the New Zealand Olympic team.
Kia ora, good evening. First tonight, the harrowing images a mother wants you to see of her baby battling for every breath. The Waikato mums released the pictures to One News with a plea to parents to take action against a deadly epidemic.
She says her daughter's heart stopped beating more than once during a five-week fight against whooping cough. This from health reporter Lauralee Mason, but we warn you may find some images distressing.
It's heart-wrenching to watch. A three-week-old baby struggling for each breath, having mucus suctioned from her lungs, being winded as she gasps for air. Tough to observe, but far tougher for a parent to stand by helplessly and watch.
Fear, just fear that she wasn't going to start breathing again. I was very scared.
Sativa Illingworth is now home in Te Araha, but the memory of her close shave with death is hard for mum Stacey to shake. She was discovered in her cot, blue and not responding, and rushed to Waikato Hospital, where she went into cardiac arrest.
The whole ICU team were there and I had to walk out the room. It was just that full on. I didn't think she was going to pull through.
She stopped breathing repeatedly over the next 5 weeks. Stacey Illingworth says she gave permission to have her baby's ordeal filmed to convince more parents to vaccinate on time.
Some of the areas where we have the high levels of whooping cough are also the areas with lower levels of coverage.
Sativa was too young for her first vaccination and may have caught it from an only partially immunised baby or an adult whose immunity had lapsed over time. The Health Ministry is now urging adults to line up for booster shots.
It's a small price to pay to know that you are not going to be the person who passes on whooping cough to your grandchild or niece or nephew.
Nearly 5,000 New Zealanders have contracted whooping cough in the past 12 months. There have been 400 cases in the past few weeks alone. So far this year, there's been one death and 158 hospitalisations. 96 of those cases were babies under 1 year old.
One in 10 babies hospitalised with whooping cough ends up here in a neonatal intensive care unit. But even with the constant 24-hour surveillance, they have a 1 in 6 chance of dying or ending up with permanent brain or lung damage.
Stacey Illingworth's hope now is that others will see this and act. Lauralee Mason, One News.
This One News update is brought to you by ANZ, proud sponsor of the New Zealand Olympic team.